BRC, and so.
Oh, check y'all out.
We're BRC, and so our grade level, fourth grade, we're doing culture, 4.2 AC, and 1.14 B, explain how people in different regions of Texas, explore whether wrong, living past and present through substance economy and providing services and identify and compare characteristics of Spanish colonial government and the Army Mexican government, their influence and the inhabitants of Texas. So these kids are really going to research where they come from and what their family has have done and exactly what cities they came from. So our objective is the students will report their culture and create a corrido that depicts their history. And they will need maps and articles, arts, different corridos, historical documents, internet access, iPads, family members for oral history. And the purpose is to recenter the story of who we are and where we come from. And we have a video here, the little corrido, es una forma musical, like I said, literaria, popular en la área cultural mestiza mexicana. This is what that video is about.
It's similar to the corrido video that we did, which I thought maybe we can open up a corrido and then maybe we can ask them and see what they think about what a corrido is and what it means to them or if they have any knowledge of it.
Okay, so the kids are going to have several weeks to do this, and so we're going to give them a rubric or some type of questions to go home and ask. So what's your mother's name? Where was she? What's her maiden name? Where was she born? Do they know what a maiden name is? Where was she born? Who were her parents? And what city did they come from? And what state were they born in? And then the same thing with the father. And then from there, you're going to get the grandparents' information, do the same thing until you can go back as far as you can. So we want them to go back as far as they can, find out exactly what cities and what states or what countries they came from, because you just never know. And go back as far as you can. And of course, you're going to have kids, they're going to struggle with the information because of the language. Maybe they don't know, maybe they don't speak Spanish, maybe they don't speak English, and you kind of have to work with the kids and their information there. And so the teacher's going to be readily available to facilitate all information, and help with these kids, because they just, some might not know, some might not have the internet at home, or to work in class, or even parents, they might be adopted, or maybe they're foster kids. So there's a lot of other things that you have to really think about when doing a project like this. So, and they're going to keep a daily journal entry to record all the information that they gather. So, and then when they're done, their final project is to create a corrido of their family history. And so this is going to be about 6 weeks worth of work to be done during social studies time, and hopefully they could have it done for Christmas to give as a gift to their family. And if time is, they can implement maybe, I want to use GarageBand, maybe add some music to it. Get some lyrics going.
Maybe the music teacher can help.
And we even thought they could even be creative. They can do the song, they can do a poem, they can do just something in regards to their family, but